Yellowstone Volcano, a supervolcano with two magma chambers. The last time it erupted, the world was plunged into volcanic winter that spanned decades. And guess what? Honey is due an eruption. But what would that mean for America? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that, let's face it, likes to answer basically whatever you want to know. We're like a 5-minute long explanatory version of Ask Jeeves, and you love it! I'm your host, Rebecca Folgate, and today I'm asking, could the Yellowstone Volcano eruption destroy America? Any Americans watching? Are you ready for the answer? Before we get into this video, why don't you guys let me know where you live? And then, when we get to the end of the video, fun game, you can let me know whether or not you'd survive a Yellowstone eruption. Sounds like fun? Also, while you're down there, why don't you like this video and click on the notification bell? Also, there's all kinds of links in the description box to the creative team behind this video and my Instagram if you want a face reveal. Okay, Yellowstone, what do you have for us? A lot of death and destruction, it seems like. Nice one. So the Yellowstone volcano is located in Wyoming, and she last blew 6,400 years ago. The eruption before that took place 1.3 million years ago, and the one before that 2.1 million years ago. The time between the first and second explosion was about 800,000 years. The next came much quicker at 660,000 years, and now it's been 640,000 years since the last. Worrying. Theoretically, she could blow at any minute, but then again, she may need several more millennia. If she did blow, though, well, get ready. The prior three eruptions at Yellowstone wreaked havoc in the past, and there weren't any humans around to suffer the consequences. The first eruption spread ash over most of North America and generated a 50-mile-wide Island Park caldera crater in Yellowstone. Another eruption would further change the landscape, but that isn't really the most concerning thing here. And neither is the hot lava. Firstly, those within an 80 to 100 kilometer radius of the eruption zone would be killed instantly by the hot burning ash. Salt Lake City and Boise are very much in the kill zone, with the high death tolls in Rapid City and Denver. Pretty much the entire states of Ohio, Wyoming, Utah, and Montana would be a mess, with Washington, Oregon, Nevada, and Colorado also suffering heavily. You want to know how much of the United States would be affected? Well, have a look at this map showing the ash spread. Basically, only Miami and the very southern tip of Austin are reasonably unaffected. Yes, the majority of the people in the death zone could and would be evacuated, but the entirety of the United States can't be evacuated because, obviously. So suffice to say, there would be a great deal of chaos. It's hard to say how many people would die because monitoring the volcano would give us some forewarning. Nonetheless, some experts say that 90,000 people would die immediately from the hot burning ash, with tens of millions more affected by the fallout. It wouldn't just be the United States severely injured either. An eruption of Yellowstone would greatly harm Canada, especially Calgary and Winnipeg, which has a combined population of nearing 2 million. Toronto, the city I live in, would also be covered in anywhere between 3 to 10 millimeters of ash, which is enough to harm those with respiratory issues and cause significant damage to infrastructure. Not only would people and animals burn and choke, but the ash would damage buildings, causing the temporary shutdown of power plants and telecommunications, pollute water supplies, and smother crops. The worst damage, of course, would be in the neighboring regions, but as you can see from the ash fallout map, pretty much every single area of the United States would be affected on some level. The United States airspace would be a mess, and the ash would and could affect flights across the world. In the United States alone, the eruption of Yellowstone would incur upwards of $3 trillion in economic damages, so 20% of the United States GDP. As a result of this severe economic downturn, people in the states would starve, and other countries who rely heavily on United States exports would also be affected. In the past, similar supervolcano eruptions have lowered global temperatures. This has even gone on for several years. Now, this could devastate crop production worldwide, not just in the United States. It isn't just people that would suffer. It's pretty hard to evacuate animals, which would mean a lot would die in the death zone, and scores more would have their habitats buried in ash. What this would mean for the worldwide ecosystem, we just don't know. On top of that, the world, yes world, would be plunged into a decade-long winter. Oh, and it hardly seems worth mentioning, what with all the death and destruction and possible Westeros-style seasons, but a Yellowstone eruption would also be smelly. The sulfur sure is hard on the old nose. We don't know when Yellowstone will erupt. It is a literal ticking time bomb waiting to take down North America. However, NASA may have the answer as to how to save the hundreds of millions of people it will affect. Yes, NASA. NASA believes that drilling 10 kilometers down into the supervolcano and pumping in water at a high pressure could cool it. A cost of nearing $3.5 billion, NASA thinks it is the most viable solution to save the continent from the disaster that would be an eruption. It sounds expensive, but the heat could also be used as geothermal plants to generate electric power, although the process could take hundreds of years and, if it was conducted poorly, could actually spark the eruption it's trying to prevent. So, could the Yellowstone volcano eruption destroy America? Well, it could severely wound it, that's for sure. And it could take a good old bite out of Canada and other parts of the world, too. The United States is a rich country and could deal with this natural disaster as well, if not better, than any other country in the world. However, the economic damage caused over the time needed to repair could knock the states off their podium of superpower status, paving the way for Russia and China to be top dogs. Hopefully, for the lives of the Americans and Canadians it could destroy, the Yellowstone volcano won't erupt in our lifetime. Indeed, there is only a very small chance that it could actually happen in the next 1,000 years, so don't worry too much. So that is one big question answered for you. What do you think? Do you agree with the answer? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, where are you living? Do you think that you would be affected? Let me know. Also, while you're down there, why don't you hit on that thumbs up button and stay subscribed for more big answers. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.